In this video, we're deriving the reduction formula for the integral of tangent to the nth power, where n is an integer greater than 1. Now, this isn't a formula that I would recommend memorizing, but I just put it on a calculus exam to see if students could generalize from their experience integrating powers of the tangent function to end up deriving this somewhat popular formula. And I think it's instructive to start out with just a simple example. Suppose we were asked to integrate the fourth power of the tangent function. What would you do with this integral? And the common trick here is to split off a factor of tangent squared. And the leftover piece is also tangent squared in this case because we started with tangent to the fourth. And then we replace that tangent squared with a secant squared minus 1. And the advantage of this is that after we distribute the tangent squared to both of these terms, the first term is going to have the derivative of the tangent function, that's secant squared, stuck right on a power of the tangent function. So this first piece has the chain rule taken care of already because the derivative of the tangent function is sitting next to a power of the tangent function. This piece simply integrates to 1/3 tangent cubed. If it makes you uncomfortable to go through it that fast, just check by taking the derivative of that term. First, you differentiate with respect to the tangent function, and the 3 cancels the 1/3, and the power becomes a 2. And then you tack on the derivative of the tangent function, which is secant squared, and we get back where we started. The second piece is an integral of tangent squared x. And I'm not going to finish that part, but you would handle that one also by just replacing the square of the tangent with secant squared minus 1. The point here is to illustrate by example that this power reduction formula works. I started with an n of 4. I ended up with 1 over 4 minus 1 times tangent to the 4 minus 1, right, tangent cubed, minus the integral of a power of the tangent function that is 2 less than what we started with. So the power reduction formula just comes from using the standard trick that we always use for powers of the tangent function. And my derivation goes like this. I have the integral of the nth power of the tangent function. What do I do to solve powers of the tangent function? I split off a tangent squared with the intent of using this Pythagorean identity. What I'm left with is a tangent to the n minus 2 power. And then I apply that identity and I get secant squared x minus 1 tangent to the n minus 2 of x dx. And then we distribute the power of tangent to both of these terms and I end up with an integral of secant squared x. That's the derivative of the tangent function sitting right next to a power of the tangent function. So the chain rule is taken care of on that term. And then I have a leftover term that's just a tangent to the n minus 2 of x dx. And again, the first term has already been set up for the chain rule backwards. I can just use the power rule on the tangent function. I add 1 to the exponent and divide by the result. So I have a 1 over n minus 1, tangent to the n minus 1 of x, and then minus my leftover piece, which is the integral tangent to the n minus 2 x dx. And I don't do proofs very often on my channel, so I'm not going to miss the opportunity to say QED because I finished my proof and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.